I am Ra. I greet you, my friends, in the love and in the light of the one infinite creator. We communicate now. Question 82.1. Questioner, could you first please give me the condition of the instrument? Answer, I am Ra. It is as previously stated. Question 82.2. Questioner, is there anything at all that we could do that we are not doing, besides eliminating the contact, to increase the physical energy of the instrument? Answer, I am Ra. There is the probability that the whirling of the water with spine erect would alter somewhat the distortion towards what you call pain which this entity experiences in the dorsal region on a continuous level. This in turn could aid in the distortion towards increase of physical energy to some extent. Question 82.3. Questioner, Jim has a personal question that has not to be published. He asks, it seems that my balancing work has shifted from more peripheral concerns such as patience, impatience, to learning to open myself in unconditional love, to accepting on myself as whole and perfect, and then to accepting myself as the creator. If this is a normal progression of focus for balancing, wouldn't it be more efficient once this is discovered for a person to work on the acceptance of the self as creator rather than work peripherally on the secondary and tertiary results of not accepting the self? Answer, I am Ra. The term efficiency has misleading connotations. In the context of doing work in the disciplines of the personality, in order to be of more full efficiency in the central acceptance of the self, it is first quite necessary to know the distortions of the self which the entity is accepting. Each thought and action needs must then be scrutinized for the precise foundation of the distortions of any reactions. This process shall lead to the more central task of acceptance. However, the architrave must be in place before the structure is builded. Question 82.4. Questioner, I would like to consider the condition at a time or position just prior to the beginning of this octave of experience. I am assuming that, just prior to the beginning of this octave, intelligent infinity had created and already experienced one or more previous octaves. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. You are assumed correctly. However, the phrase would more informatively read, infinite intelligence had experienced previous octaves. Question 82.5. Questioner, does Ra have any knowledge of the number of previous octaves? If so, how many? Answer, I am Ra. As far as we are aware, we are in an infinite creation. There is no counting. Question 82.6. Questioner, that's what I thought you might say. Am I correct in assuming that at the beginning of this octave, out of what I would call a void of space, seeds of an infinite number of galactic systems such as the Milky Way galaxy appeared and grew in spiral fashion simultaneously? Answer, I am Ra. They are dual areas of potential confusion. Firstly, let us say that the basic concept is reasonably well stated. Now we address the confusions. The nature of true simultaneity is such that, indeed, all is simultaneous. However, in your modes of perception you would perhaps more properly view the seeding of the creation as that of growth from the center or core outward. The second confusion lies in the term, void. We would substitute the noun, plenum. Question 82.7. Questioner, then, if I were observing the beginning of the octave at that time through our telescope, say from this position, would I see the center of many, many galaxies appearing and each of them then spreading outward in a spiraling fashion over what we would consider billions of years, but the spirals spreading outward in approximately what we would consider the same rate so that all these galaxies began as the first speck of light at the same time and then spread out at roughly the same rate? Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. The query has confusing elements. There is a center to infinity. From this center all spreads. Therefore, there are centers to the creation, to the galaxies, to star systems, to planetary systems, and to consciousness. In each case you may see growth from the center outward. Thus you may see your query as being overgeneral in concept. Question 82.8. Questioner, considering only our Milky Way galaxy at its beginnings, I will assume that the first occurrence that we could find with our physical apparatus was the appearance of a star of the nature of our sun. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. In the case of the galactic systems, the first manifestation of the Logos is a cluster of central systems which generate the outward swirling energies, producing, in their turn, further energy centers for the Logos, or what you would call stars. Question 82.9. Questioner, are these central original creations or clusters what we call stars? Answer, I am Ra. This is correct. However, the closer to the, shall we say, beginning of the manifestation of the Logos the star is, the more it partakes in the one original thought. Question 82.10. Questioner, why does this partaking in the original thought have a gradient radially outward? That's the way I understand your statement. Answer, I am Ra. This is the plan of the one infinite creator. The one original thought is the harvest of all previous, if you would use this term, experience of the creator by the creator. As it decides to know itself, it generates itself into that plenum full of the glory and the power of the one infinite creator, which is manifested to your perceptions as space or outer space. Each generation of this knowing begets a knowing which has the capacity, through free will, to choose methods of knowing itself. Therefore, gradually, step by step, the creator becomes that which may know itself, and the portions of the creator partake less purely in the power of the original word or thought. The creator does not properly create as much as it experiences itself. Question 82.11. Questioner, what was the form, condition, or experience of the first division of consciousness that occurred at the beginning of this octave, at the beginning of this galactic experience? Answer, I am Ra. We touch upon previous material. The harvest of the previous octave was the creator of love manifested in mind, body, and spirit. This form of the creator experiencing itself may perhaps be said to be the first division. Question 82.12. Questioner, I was interested specifically in how this very first division showed up in this octave. I was interested to know if it made the transition through first, second, third, fourth, etc. densities. I would like to take the first mind, body, spirit complexes and trace their experience from the very start to the present so that I could better understand the condition that we are in now by comparing it with this original growth. Could you please tell me precisely how this came about as to the formation of the planets and growth through the densities, if that is the way it happened, please? Answer, I am Ra. Your queries seem more confused than your basic mental distortions in this area. Let us speak in general, and perhaps you may find a less confused and more simple method of eliciting information in this area. A very great deal of creation was manifested without the use of the concepts involved in consciousness, as you know it. The creation itself is a form of consciousness which is unified, the Logos being the one great heart of creation. The process of evolution through this period, which may be seen to be timeless, is most valuable to take into consideration, for it is against the background of this essential unity of the fabric of creation that we find the ultimate development of the Logos, which chose to use that portion of the harvested consciousness of the Creator to move forward with the process of knowledge of self. As it had been found to be efficient to use the various densities, which are fixed in each octave, in order to create conditions in which self-conscious sub-Logos could exist, this was carried out throughout the growing flower-strewn field, as your simile suggests, of the one infinite creation. The first beings of mind, body, and spirit were not complex. The experience of mind, body, spirits at the beginning of this octave of experience was singular. There was no third density forgetting. There was no veil. The lessons of third density are predestined by the very nature of the vibratory rates experienced during this particular density and by the nature of the quantum jump to the vibratory experiences of fourth density. Question 82.13. Questioner, am I correct, then, in assuming the first mind, body, spirit experiences as this galaxy progressed in growth were those that moved through the densities? That is, the process we have discussed coming out of second density. For instance, let us take a particular planet, one of the very early planets formed near the center of the galaxy. I will assume that the planet solidified during the first density, that life appeared in second density, and that all of the mind, body, spirit complexes of third density progressed out of second density on that planet and evolved in third density. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. This is hypothetically correct. Question 82.14. Questioner, did this in fact happen on some of the planets or on a large percentage of the planets near the center of this galaxy in this way? Answer, I am Ra. Our knowledge is limited. We know of the beginning but cannot asseverate to the precise experiences of those things occurring before us. You know the nature of historical teaching. At our level of learned teaching we may expect little distortion. However, we cannot, with surety, say there is no distortion as we speak of specific occurrences of which we were not consciously a part. It is our understanding that your supposition is correct. Thus we so hypothesize. Question 82.15. Questioner, specifically, I am trying to grasp an understanding of the process of experience in third density before the veil so that I can better understand the present process. As I understand, the mind, body, spirits went through the process of what we call physical incarnation in this density, but there was no forgetting. What was the benefit or purpose of the physical incarnation when there was no forgetting? Answer, I am Ra. The purpose of incarnation in third density is to learn the ways of love.